Tyrese Wilson. What's good, man? I wanted to hit you up because I got this episode coming up, and a lot of people have been sending me email requests in regards to this topic, so I wanted to get your insight on it. And the question is, are today's relationships and marriages based more on being transactional, or are they really about love, caring, and respecting each other? A lot of people have been asking me this question. It's an episode I kind of held off for a little while because I wanted to wait for the right time, but I wanted your opinion on how you feel. Are relationships and marriages more transactional here in 2019 going into 2020? Wait to hear from you. Peace.
Hey, D, this is Tyree, man, and thank you for your question. I do believe that businesses and the transactions of the business can be akin to a marriage and how it's run and relationships. It's a very good question, very deep topic. However, I do also believe, and I believe the goal could be, that a emotional marriage, one that is based off of love and respect and integrity and, you know, things along those lines, the relationship has no bounds. You know, there's no limit to where the relationship can go, especially for the individuals involved and then together as one unit. It's a great question. It's a very deep topic. It also depends on the individuals and what they hold in respect to their personal lives and the influence that they carry out for themselves and towards one another in every single day in life. So hopefully this helps. So I wanted to keep the topic going, but the app with Anchor only allows you like 1 minute of response time. So again, this is Tyree and I'm answering your question, D. Thank you again for the question. I think it all depends on the individual still, like, or the couple. Like, if you are doing things in the relationship and it's working out well, then you'll feel happy about it because you're receiving and you're integrating progress into the relationship. And I do believe that progress is a direct link to happiness, and that includes being in a relationship. No matter what stage it's in, progress is linked directly to happiness. So if the individuals involved with one another can reach a level of progress, and no matter what level of intensity that progress is, then what happens in a marriage, it might still be transactional, but it's backed, empowered, and empowered through an emotional driver between two individuals that have chosen to live as one unit. And so to kind of end, you know, my inclusion on this topic for everyone to chew on, I think it's all about understanding that business and transactions are ruled by what's profitable and what's logical. And logic goes a long way with proving that things, no matter what systems that are involved, it proves that it works. It depends on what you do and what you don't do, and how the numbers play out, or how the results prove themselves in a business sense. However, in any business, when you're dealing with an individual or a relationship, it is the emotions that get people to move one way or another. It is emotions that get people to become more invested in you, or you invested in them in some type of positive or even negative way. But it all leads to growth.
Tyree Wilson, that was a superb answer to the question, are relationships and marriages transactional here in 2018, moving into 2020? Because in listening to my messages and looking at my emails, the majority of the people that are thinking about this particular topic, they're only looking at it from a negative standpoint. And you actually put a spin on it and actually get people to think about the positive in it. So that was a superb answer, man, because a lot of people focus on the negative. So I really appreciate that. I will be back in touch with you, man. It's making me rethink how to do this upcoming episode, man. So you're much appreciated. All right, talk to you soon. Peace.
Hey, my listener, thank you for tuning in to this episode of Lot Pop Talks. Remember, you can subscribe to the podcast and website over at www.tyreewilson.com. When you visit and subscribe, you get a free 7-day prayer devotional journal for you to keep. If you want to work one-on-one with me, you only need to email me, DM, or message me, and I will get in contact with you about how we can get started. Have a great rest of your day, and God bless.